this exhibition, really, there's no theme to the exhibition at all. So what it is essentially a celebration of the book. Romantic, not disgusting. My role here is to select the paintings for the exhibition. Quite a difficult task, of course. 190 artists in the book, and we've selected 30 here, 10 from each category: emerging, mid-career, and established. We want to have strong painting. Fortunately, the artists in the book, there was a lot of strong painting to choose from. I kind of like this cross-generational thing where we have some young artists here in their late 20s exhibiting with more senior artists, and to have their work in the same room, in the same proximity, and to stand in one spot and reference those paintings. I find that kind of exciting.
You know, I was that kid in class that loved making pictures pretty well more than anything else I could think of. Other than maybe playing for the Leafs, the only thing I ever wanted to do. This particular piece, what you're seeing is the head sort of superimposed against a vertical view of the trees in my backyard. But much like the view you would get if you were a child in a tree fort, you know, you climb into the fort and you just sort of lay in that tree fort, yeah. You know, and you look straight up, and it's that kind of view. So it seemed right to me to articulate the head in such a way that it didn't have a traditional figure-ground relationship either. And it's a show of people whose work I really love and peers whose work I really respect. And there's great painting happening right across the country. The state of painting in Canada is, you know, really terrific. And I think this book will show that.
This is a painting that's from a series called Teaser. And Teaser is inspired by animals' tails. You don't really think of a skunk as, you know, a beautiful showy thing, but when you actually take a good look at the tail, it's quite gorgeous. And so I've used skunks, and I've also used chickens, really fluffy chickens, and most recently hummingbirds. This is a daughter skunk playing with her mother, and the fluttery color that you're seeing is actually light hitting pine needles in the forest. They're like hundreds of layers of varnish to get this buildup of shimmer and depth. It's an honor because it looks to me like they've made quite a significant choice. I really, really like the choices that they made to single out specific people. And I'm really excited that they decided to stick me in the show. When it's all over, we can barely
discuss for one minute. My work has a lot of sort of different facets. This is part of the group I call the super thick paintings. Uh-huh. And they're paintings that I develop in the studio over a long time so that I can develop the sort of density and impasto. Just using paint to sort of conjure flesh and also represent my wife, who I paint pretty much exclusively. My motto has always been, let your work do the work for you. And my theory is that if the harder I work in the studio, the harder the paintings will work for me. It's an amazing book. The show is awesome. I'm looking around at some really terrific paintings, and I think it's about time Canada put something like this out. For sure. We've got a lot of talent here.
The intensity of the color meant a lot to me, to working one color off another and having that sort of dynamic of things that shouldn't go together but do go together, and trying to kind of have some kind of edge to it. I love painting in general, so I see a lot of stuff that impresses me, so I think that's the catalyst. That's what keeps you going. And a lot of it is to do with engaging the world, you know, and I think other mediums have become very mechanized, I guess. And painting is still, much like poetry, it's one hand doing one thing for a long time until something happens. And I think very young people are really interested in that because it's almost, in a sense, everybody's embracing technology, but at the same time, people are thinking, okay, what are we leaving behind?
Oh, Carte Blanche Volume 1 and Carte Blanche Volume 2, books like that, we do not publish with enough frequency in Canadian art, and if we want to have gain any respect and visibility on the international scene, we have to be coming out with books like this. Let's say 5, 10, 20 years down the road, people look back, and this is an encapsulated important moment in Canadian painting history. This book is a major addition to the knowledge and lineage of contemporary Canadian art.